Okay, in this video, I'm going to be talking about LangChain agents. LangChain agents are one of the key things that makes LangChain so useful. They take LangChain tools, which we've looked at in some of the other videos, and chains, which we've looked at in other videos, and combine them into one agent. So one of the problems with just tools and chains alone is that you probably don't want to use the same tool for every query that the user has. So you don't want to have everything answered by the math calculator or something like that, right? You want to basically be able to have people converse with a bunch of different things. And this is what agents allow you to do. So agents have an executor level where they look at the input, they then decide what is the best tool based on what you've initialized the tools for this particular bot. And then they allow you to actually use those in relation to what the person's asking. So let's jump in and have a look at the code here. You can see I've got just the standard pip installs. We're going to be using Wikipedia later on, so I put Wikipedia in there. We basically just initialize things. We will need a search engine API key for doing this. You will want to set that up. And we're going to just start off by creating an agent. So to create an agent, we do two main things. We load in the tools that the agent is going to be using. And then we initialize the agent with those tools. And you'll see as we go through what actually initializing it is doing, or parts of what it's doing. So we're going to have a language model here. We're just using the standard OpenAI model. We're setting temperature to zero. And here I'm going to start off with two tools. So we're going to do an agent that can do two tools. The first one is just going to be doing search with the search API. And the second one is going to be doing some math, so like a calculator tool. And if we look at these tools, so once we've initialized this, we can come and look into these. We can see that they've got a name and a description. And looking at this second one here, we've got the name being calculator. And this is useful for math questions and questions that relate to math. If you look into it, there's a lot of things actually in the tool, right? We've got the templates, we've got a whole bunch of the different chains that are actually made up for that tool there. Once we've got the tools set up, we want to initialize the agent. So initializing the agent requires a few key things. We need to pass in the tools. We need to pass in our language model. We then need to pass in the style of the agent or the type of the agent. So in this case, we're going to be using zero-shot React agent. So this is based on a paper about getting language models to take actions and generate steps for taking actions. I may actually do a whole video about the paper. The paper is very interesting of how you can prompt a model to give you back things that you can then use to take actions on. Anyway, one of the big things that initializing the agent does is it sets up the sort of executor prompt. And if we look at this, you'll see, let me just copy this here and we come in and paste it. We will see that, okay, we've got the following questions. So this is the prompt that we're looking at, right? And this is the prompt that gets executed at the start for the language model to decide what it should be doing. So we've got answer the following questions as best you can. You have access to the following tools. So a search engine, right? So we've got search, which is what we passed in first as the first tool, and a calculator is what we passed in the second tool. So it knows that it can use these two tools. And then the following format is what it should be returning. So it's going to determine what's the question that it has to answer. And then it can, to use a bad way of describing this, I would say self-reflect. If it was a human, it self-reflects, but it's a language model. We don't want to anthropomorphize it too much, but you can think of this a little bit as it's doing a self-reflection of that, what is it going to need to do? And then it decides the action to take. So in this case, this could be search or calculator. And then it decides the input to that action. So if it's going to do a search, it needs to have a search query. And that's what will go in here. The observation that it will get back will be the result of the action. So you can see that this is where it's going to start generating this. And then it's going to have this sort of scratch pad that goes along with it. So if we kick this off, you need to understand too that it doesn't always have to use a tool. So here we just ask it, okay, agent.run, we pass in our text. How are you today? And so you can see we've got verbose equals true, so we can see the outputs of these nicely. We can see that, okay, we're entering the agent executor chain. And then it says that, okay, this question, how are you today, is not a question that can be answered with search or a calculator. So it doesn't need an action. It doesn't need an action input. This is a question that requires a personal answer. So it can generate the answer. And you can see the answer that it generates, I'm doing well, thank you. So that one didn't use any of the tools. So the next one we run is we ask, okay, who is the United States president? What is his current age divided by 2? So this clearly is going to need some tools, right? So it basically says, okay, what's the question that it needs to solve? The question it needs to solve is I need to find out who the president of the United States is and then calculate his age divided by 2. So the first action is search. And so it decides to do a search, United States. It then comes up with Joe Biden. Then the thought is I need to find Joe Biden's age. The action, next action, search. So Joe Biden's age gets the answer back. And you see the different colors here is showing the different, that this tool was has been used and has returned the answer. The answer back is 80 years. Okay, I now need to divide by 80 by 2. So what's the action? Now it's a calculator. So we've got the calculator doing action 80 divided by 2. Equals 40. Final thought that it thinks to itself as it goes through these is that, okay, I know the final answer. Joe Biden is 80 years old and his age divided by 2 is 40. So there it's used multiple steps to get the answer. And it's actually used multiple tools to get the answer there. The next one, let's try the next one. What is the average age in the United States and how much less is that than the age of the current US president? So again, it starts off going for search. So it basically decides what it needs to do, goes for search. It then works out it needs to get the average age in the United States, right, is the input to the search. So it's gone along and got some stats for that. Obviously, that's quite a long one in there. Then it basically needs to find the age of the current president. It does that. And then it says, okay, I know the final answer. And then it gives us this, the average age in the United States is approximately 38 years, which is 42 years less than the current US president. So this sort of shows you this idea of stringing multiple tools together to get an answer. So let's try a new agent. Let's say we take an agent and we're going to pass in multiple tools now. We're going to pass in much more than just 2. We're going to add Wikipedia and we're going to add the terminal output for this. We initialize our agent the same. We've got the zero-shot React description, and then we've got our prompt. So let's look at the prompt again. We'll just paste the prompt in here so we can just see it easily. And we can see that the prompt's exactly the same, except now we've got more tools. We've got search, we've got calculator, we've got Wikipedia, we've got terminal going in here. The rest of it is exactly the same. So let's jump in with this and we ask it first, okay, who is the head of DeepMind? So for this, it decides, okay, best way to find this is to do a search. And you need to realize for some of these things, there are multiple ways for it to find out. But here it's decided, okay, I'm just going to do a search head of DeepMind. And it comes back Demis Hassabis. And so then it rephrases that, uses the language model to rephrase that based on the question, Demis Hassabis is the head of DeepMind. So now we ask, well, what is DeepMind? So it works out that, okay, this is a company. It seems to have that in the knowledge of the language model itself. But it says, okay, this is a company, so I should look it up on Wikipedia. So now it does a search on Wikipedia for DeepMind. And it, sure enough, what does it return back? It returns back one page about the actual company. And one page, it gets a little bit confused. It returns back a page about Gato, which is one of the models that DeepMind did. It uses this collective information that's being fed into the prompt to then basically decide on the final answer. And the final answer that it comes up with is DeepMind is a British artificial intelligence research laboratory founded in 2010. It gives us, is now a subsidiary of Alphabet, gives us more information there. So now if we say, next off, I wanted to do some math, right? But didn't work, you'll see. That I say, okay, take the year that DeepMind was founded, which we know is 2010, and add 50 years. And then I ask it, will this year have AGI? Okay, so it needs to basically work out first, okay, when was DeepMind founded, and then add 50 years to that. So it looks DeepMind again on Wikipedia to get the founding date for that. And then it says, okay, DeepMind was founded in 2010, so adding 50 years brings it up to 2060. It hasn't used the math module. It's been able to do that itself. I guess the math is so simple that the language model can do that. And then it doesn't do a search, right? You would think that, okay, now it's going to do some searches about that. And it decides, no, it's going to just answer this itself. So I don't know if this is OpenAI's sort of conditioning of the model and prompting of the model internally or fine tuning of the model about answers to AGI. Because see, the answer that it comes back with is it's impossible to predict whether AGI will exist in 2060. Okay, let's move on. So then I'm thinking, I really want one that's going to use search. So let's try, where is DeepMind's office? And sure enough, for this one, it basically says, oh, okay, that's going to be a search. And then it does a search for DeepMind office address. And it's nice that it's added the word address. It's gotten what I'm asking for here. And you can see it returns back for this. Now, we still didn't get to use our math module in this agent, so I wanted to show that as well. So we try one more of, okay, if I square the number of the street address of DeepMind, what answer do I get? So now it's got to do the search to get the address. Then it's got to take this 5, the street address, and square it. And sure enough, it's able to return 25. Now, you will find sometimes that it will get, you know, with some things, it will get confused. If there are multiple numbers in there, it could have squared the 3 or the 4 if it got mistaken. So that's something you can think about. There are ways that you can handle that kind of thing, of that you could get a prompt back. So if you were doing a lot of things with addresses, you could format the prompt to come back as street number in quotes with the word street number or something, road or the street name, postcode, all these things separately. So that then when you feed them into the next thing, it's less likely to make them. Anyway, then so we've done that, right? So we've covered a number of the different tools in here. The one that we haven't used yet is Terminal. So I ask it, okay, so remember, this is the same agent. I haven't made a new agent here. This is the same agent. And I ask, what files are in my current directory? So let's have a quick look. I'm on Colab. I've got a very standard sample data that they give you with MNIST and a few sort of CSV files in there. So I ask it, what files are in my current directory? And sure enough, it works out that, oh, this action needs a terminal. So it runs an ls command, sees some things in there. So then it decides, okay, I'll look in this folder, sample data, and it then gives us a bit more information about that. We can see what's out there. And then it gives us a nice list of, okay, these are all the files that are in there. Then I ask it, okay, so then I was curious, like, okay, if we ask it about a specific file, what can it find in there? So I ask it, does my current directory have a file about California? So you can see this goes into a long chain with many steps in here. And this is where some agents can get quite expensive to run because you're doing lots of these calls to your language model to get a single answer. But you can see here, it's pretty impressive what it does. It goes through, rather than just go through and look at, I was curious to see whether it would take this and do the search, do the sort of text search in the language model itself. But no, it does it with a grep command. So it basically does a grep for California and goes through and looks at the different folders in there and then obviously finds some in there and then returns to me, yes, there is a file about California in the current directory. And we could also ask things like, what is that file, that kind of thing. I suggest you be very careful adding the terminal tool to what it is that you're working on, because you wouldn't want end users to be able to wipe everything on your hard drive just by asking your language model to run a terminal command. So be careful with that, but there probably are times where it's quite useful, at least for yourself to use or that kind of thing, if you're setting up something like that. So this covers agents. As always, if you've got any questions that you would like to ask, please put them in the comments. I'm happy to answer questions, stuff that people have. If there's any topics that you want me to cover about LangChain or about other deep learning models, etc., let me know. And as always, if this was useful to you, please click and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.